The U.S. did some unorthodox efforts in order to take Fidel Castro out of power.
Alright, we're CIA Strike Team Alpha. We're here, midday Cuba, to get Fidel Castro. Let's do this. He's walking right over there.
This may not make much sense, but, you know, we did eventually establish NASA. It went something like this, I think.
It's a nice soundtrack.
One fateful day in 1963, the Bean Eater was finally put to rest.
Jackie, he has slain me. Ich bin ein dead. No!
That same fateful day, Lyndon B. Johnson was inaugurated on Air Force One.
LBJ! Apparently Kennedy was just killed. We need you.
Okay.
Put your right hand in the Bible.
But this is a dictionary.
I know. It's better. It's Merriam-Webster's College Dictionary, featuring seven new words.
Okay, those seven words will help, I guess.
Alright, repeat after me.
Oh, Canada, my home and native land. True. Okay, I thought I'm supposed to be the President of the United States, not the whatever.
Oh, okay. I'm terribly sorry. Stuck in my head all day. Alright. Ah, LBJ. Want to be the president today.
Want to be the president today.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right, we're good. All right, that's all it took.
I guess I'm president now.
Yep.
After U.S. ships were attacked on the Gulf of Tonkin, Big Johnson wanted action.
We need to take action. South Vietnam is going to get overrun by communism. A ship has already been sunk off the Gulf of Tonkin. We need to declare war immediately on North Vietnam to stop communism right now.
Alrighty, everybody sign this Gulf of Tonkin resolution.
Alright, go ahead, declare war.
Okay. Mr. President,
let's go.
We trust you.
Destroy all of North Vietnam.
Okay.
Thus, the Vietnam War began. A complete and total failure for the U.S. None other than yours truly, Richard Nixon, ended Vietnam. And then I did something else, but you know.
Vietnam War has unarguably been a complete and total failure for the Americans. Our soldiers have been over there unprepared, totally not ready for what they were going to face. And none of that, it doesn't matter anyway. South Vietnam fell to communism in the end. And as such, I'm announcing a complete and total withdrawal from Vietnam.
Yes!
And on that note, we're leaving Laos.
Yeah!
Let's get over here, guys.
Oh, God, here we go again.
Yours truly visited China. Majestic place where they have dragons.
And then we got this place.
Amazing. Oh, they got singers over in China, too.
Yeah, I know, right?
Those are great. A nice grill.
You know, right?
Wow.
Look at that chip. Look at that. That's a quality one.
These Chinese know what to do. Wow, we can recognize these guys. Look at that window. I've never seen windows in America.
I know, right? We're top of the line. We're on top of the line. And our army is at rest. What is going on here?
What's that?
And you're playing Game Boy? I'm glad you're at least supporting the Chinese economy. Where's your gun?
I lost it.
You lost your gun.
Amazing.
Well, I got a better gun for you.
What mysterious people and their weapons. Amazing.
Now put the Game Boy away and you guys get out of here.
Your people are fantastic, sir.
Well, have a seat, sir. Let us discuss our differences.
Well, you know, we don't really recognize you guys as a country. I don't think that's right. I think the Chinese is a representation.
I agree. We should also represent America.
Yeah. Oh, we can work out something, man. You know what? How about a trade agreement?
Yeah, we should do that.
Trade agreement. Shake that. Is that what you Chinese people do? Think you bow or something?
Yeah, we do bow. You know what? All we'll right. Shake the American way.
Hey, you know what's funny?
And then we
keep bow. I found a little dog named Checkers at home. You guys do dogs here in China?
No. Okay. I'm sorry to hear about your dog.
Yeah. Yeah. It's kind of a nasty little thing. Anyway. Yeah, Chinese!
Yeah. I wasn't a crook! I wasn't a crook!
National Convention in there. You're a spy. We get some papers. Nixon needs these papers. Next election coming up. I mean, you know, I really need to win this one, guys. You really need to do this for me. Can you do it for me?
Yes.
Yeah. To win for Nixon.
An evil victory.
Play for Nixon. Wait, what's going to say?
Use the Watergate Hotel. I think the Dems left it in here. Find those papers.
Hey guys, room service? You need anything?
We're Democrats. We left some papers in here.
Yeah. Nothing suspicious going on.
Just papers, and you got a dictionary. Okay. This is
Shirley Chicago. I'll be back. I'll see you again.
All right, come on, let's go.
What'd you do?
He locked it. Oh no. Oh no.
Hey, what are you doing?
Drop the guns, run!
Good attack, dog. Yes. Yeah.
The peanut president met with Egypt and Israel to attempt to negotiate land for Palestine.
Here comes the Egyptian diplomatic over there. Yes, sir, he comes.
The Palestinians need a place to live. You well, Jews kick them out of their land. It's terrible.
It's terrible. Our land.
No.
They fought for it, and they lost.
No.
They fought against their government, and we kicked them out.
Can't be all this game longer.
No!
No!
Please. Well, you say it like that. Okay.
While Carter was president, Iranian students took U.S. Embassy staff members hostage.
We'll take the Americans. Yes. We will show them what it means to be Iranian!
Yes!
American scum! You're a hostage! You're a hostage! Especially you! Tell your President Jimmy Carter, you will need to negotiate for your life!
Carter attempted to negotiate for the hostages, Not much of a man, though.
People, there has to be in the country of Iran. We must negotiate with the Iran.
Excuse me, Mr. Carter, you're speaking too quietly.
Oh, did my people go?
A public service announcement from President Ronald Reagan.
I've reached my limit with these Iran hostages. Let my people go!
I see what you did here.
Ronald Reagan made some very famous speeches during his presidency. Old Nixon's memory's failing on him. I can't quite remember them all. I think they all went something like this.
Are you better off than you were 4 years ago because communism is evil? Well, let me tell you something. I was watching a movie a couple nights ago called Star Wars, and it taught me about Reaganomics and that Nelson Mandela is evil. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall.
I, Gorbachev, I'm going to tear down this wall. Booyah.
Huh?
Wasn't that fantastic, kids?
It could have improved.
I loved it! Shut up.
No.
Wow! That was a total truth right there. I've never lied once in my life, and I didn't lie there. There's no influences there, folks. No commies, no liberals, no Dems. They all try to slander the good Richard Nixon name, but I'm better than that. Richard Nixon will forever be victorious!
Yeah. What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
Yeah.
What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
Say it again, y'all.
What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
Listen to me.